Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 7 in our first musculoskeletal lab. And in this lab, we are going to focus on teeth. We're going to focus on the dentition. And really, while we talked about the juvenile dentition in the lecture videos, we're really only going to ask you to identify the adult dentition, or what they would look like in an adult. And fortunately, the shape of the teeth are going to be pretty similar between adults and juveniles. So, in terms of incisors, you are going to have a central incisor on both sides, as well as a lateral incisor. And these are often referred to as kind of shovel-shaped. They do not have any cusps associated with them, or multiple cusps, excuse me. And they are fairly nondescript in terms of their shape. As you can see here, the central incisors, when we're talking about the maxillary teeth, are going to be larger than the lateral incisors. The canines are going to be next to the lateral incisors and the premolars, and generally they have a bit more of a sharper border right here, but not always, and this definitely will get worn down with age as well. But these tend to be a little bit larger than the lateral incisors. And then when we're looking at this anterior view, you begin to kind of not be able to view quite as well the other teeth, but you will have two premolars. And then you will have molars back here, of which you will have three. So if we were to kind of go through the quadrants of these, you will have two incisors, one canine, two premolars or bicuspids, and three molars. Keeping in mind that third molar is what we colloquially refer to as the wisdom teeth and are often removed. And if you look again at this view here, you can see this a little bit better. You can see this is your, this is an incisor, this is an incisor, this is a canine, and then you get into your two premolars, which you can see on a, you can see better on a lateral view, and then your three molars. And you will have the similar organization in terms of the mandibular teeth. Now, in terms of the incisors on the mandibular teeth, these are going to be smaller than what you had on the maxillary portion, but they are going to be similar in shape, just on a much smaller scale. And so those are the dentition. If we were to ask you, or if I were to ask you a question on assessment or identification, I would have the whole suite of teeth, so you'd be able to see the neighboring teeth as well. And if you can kind of understand the numbers, that will help you in terms of being able to identify the specific types of teeth. All right. Excellent. Thank you for your time and attention here. And as always, please feel free to reach out with any questions.